So, faith. What is faith? Well, according to dictionary.com, a very reliable source, faith is confidence or trust in a person or thing. But is that really the case, or is it so much more? In many parts of the Bible, various people, such as Jesus as well as the Apostle Paul, say many different things about faith. In Matthew 17, Jesus shows faith as being powerful when he says to his disciples, "Because of your little faith, for truly I tell you, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, 'Move from here to there,' and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you." In 1 Corinthians chapter 2, Paul describes faith as a sort of trust or reliance, when he writes, "So that your faith might not rest on human wisdom, but on the power of God." But I believe faith is the belief that no matter what life throws my way, God's still going to help me get through it, even if how he gets me through it may not seem like the best way. When I was 5 years old, my parents told my sister and I that we were moving to Maryland because Dad got a job there. I didn't want to move. We had moved to Texas from Illinois just the year before, and I was just getting settled in. They finally convinced me that going to Maryland was a good idea, but I still wasn't sold on it. We moved to Maryland, and soon after that, a hurricane hit Texas around where we lived. My little 5-year-old brain didn't know it at the time, but my faith in God had grown at that point. A little bit after that, we came here to Prince of Peace. My parents had been taking my sister and I to church for a while, as well as teaching us about God in our own time, so I was pretty used to going to church. And everyone here was friendly when we came, and I had faith that God had found the right church for us. In about February that year, I got a notice that I would be going to first grade math for the rest of the year, even though I was in kindergarten. A few years ago, I just learned that the other kindergartners at the other elementary school, right where we live, didn't get that opportunity, so I had faith that God had chosen the right place for us to live so I could get into that school. This past year, I had a few different places where I could go to high school, and each had their advantages and disadvantages, and I had to make a choice. I had faith that God would help me make that right choice. My viewpoint on faith is extremely well shown by Hebrews chapter 11, which says, "Now, faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen." This relates to my stance on faith very directly. It's almost just direct translation of it. God assures that whatever happens will be a mystery, and we have to believe that those mysteries will be made real, and God will help us through it. Hebrews 11 also gives some examples of this, including one about Noah. It says, "By faith, Noah, warned by God by events as yet unseen, respected the warning and built an ark to save his household. By this, he condemned the world and became an heir to the righteousness that is in accordance with faith." Noah had faith in God that what God told him to do was the right thing, even though it may have seemed far-fetched at the time. By faith, we must continue to do the right thing in God's name. By faith, we have to keep serving God so we can get a place in his holy kingdom when the last day comes. By faith, I'll keep studying God's word to grow in this faith that I'm speaking of. By faith, I'll strive to learn more of the marvelous things God has done so I can try to do similar things to others. So, faith may still be trust in something or belief in something, but I believe faith is knowing that God will help us during whatever life brings, good or bad, even if what happens doesn't seem sensible at the time.
This past summer, I attended VBS at the preschool games along with my friend Vincent. In preschool games, chose a game that corresponds with the daily lesson. Some of the daily lessons are comics and problems with you, so on. Some of the games are simple and some are hard. If we finish our game early, we have a parachute that the kids can fill when we blow bubbles. This year, there are only two groups of preschoolers, so we had two game sessions and two free sessions. In the free sessions, we hung out with the older game leaders. I had a great time running preschool games, but one of the lessons stuck out to me most. I'm going to call it the clothespin game. In the clothespin game, we placed an index card on the shoulders of the children and told them to shake it off. They all shook it off with ease. Then we put the clothespin to their collar, and once again, told them to shake it off. They couldn't shake the clothespin off because we just put it to their collar. The lesson in the clothespin game was to show the kids that God said the clothespin. He is always with you, and you can't shake him off. This lesson impacted me most out of all the other lessons that Vincent had taught because it was so simple and understandable. When I'm feeling down or overwhelmed about stuff going inside out of school, I think of how God is like a clothespin kind of attached to me. He's there when I need him most. There's a Chinese proverb that says, give a man a fish and feed him for a day. Teach a man a fish and feed him for a lifetime. You could have told me that God is always with me, and I would have said, okay. But if you showed me how God is always with me, like the clothespin gave me, I would carry that lesson throughout life. In the time since, I realized that God is with everybody, everywhere, all the time. He cares about us individuals when there are larger problems in the world, such as war, poverty, and starvation. In the upcoming summer of 2018, we go to the youth gathering. The destination is Houston, Texas. After the hurricanes this summer and the growing threat of climate change, I believe we will witness a similar pattern of events to what happened last year. And I think that being in Houston and helping the people recover from the hurricane damage will be an important staple in my faith journey. One of the reasons I feel this will be an important on my faith journey is because I've heard it's an important moment in other people's faith journey. You may have been wondering if you saw my banner at the clothespin, so now you know. Now you know what the clothespin means. In the future, I hope to be proactive and find new ways to get myself closer to God and continue my journey with faith. Thanks for listening to my faith journey.
From one singular experience. Instead, my faith has been shaped throughout my life by acts of God's love. My faith is one of the biggest acts of God's love in my life. Being given such a great family is definitely a way I can see that God is active in my life. Through the unconditional love for me, I first learned what love is. In addition, they gave me a strong foundation to build my faith upon. From the time I was a baby, my mom would read Bible stories, play Christian music, and pray with me. As I grew a bit older, my sister, cousin, and I would hang out and watch VeggieTales. And through the years, my mom and aunt would discuss everyday situations and current events looking through the lens of God's love. Because of my family, God's presence and love have always been constant in my life. And they have never been something that I have had to question. My family is not only an act of God's love in my life, the members of my family are also the ones who helped me build my own foundation in God's love. In addition to my family, my church, Prince of Peace, has been a place for me to experience God's love and to grow in faith. My family have been members since 1997, and I have attended worship services since I was a baby, and participated in Sunday school and VBS since I was 3 years old. From the welcoming atmosphere of worship and yard sale to the camaraderie of Sunday school, VBS, and confirmation classes, I have grown in my faith. From learning in Sunday school to feeling inspired by the music and sermons in worship services, I have grown in my faith as well. Prince of Peace has also encouraged me to use my time and talents to serve God. One of my favorite ways is through VBS. When I was little, one of the highlights of my summer was VBS. It was fun and exciting, and I felt a real connection to my crew leaders. For the past 4 years, VBS has still been one of the highlights of my summer. I have loved helping with VBS by serving as a crew leader and station leader. I see VBS as a unique opportunity to share with the young kids both my faith and God's love. While my family helped me build my foundation in my faith in God, Prince of Peace has given me a community of believers to belong to. These many occurrences of God's love being active and present in my life have built my faith and trust in God. I know that God loves me unconditionally and accepts me exactly as I am. His love and this feeling of security will be with me as I continue my faith journey for the rest of my life. This is why I chose my confirmation Bible verse as 1 John chapter 4, verse 16a. And so we know and rely on the love God has for us. God is love. My knowledge that God loves me is something that I want to celebrate and share for the rest of my life. At church, I will continue to be involved in worship and Sunday school, and I hope to be able to participate in the ELCA youth gathering in Texas next summer. I will continue to volunteer for events such as yard sale and continue as a VBS station leader. In these ways and others, I will continue to spend time with other believers who are kind and supportive and with whom I can work to accomplish good things for God and share His love. In the larger world, for instance, at school, I try to share God's love by being kind, but I have not had many deep conversations with my friends about God. I know that the concept of God is that God is love and it does not have to be abstract. It is that God loves everyone, God loves you, and God loves me, and I can look for new opportunities to share that. My faith has been shaped through acts of God's love. I am looking forward to continuing to be a part of God's acts of love in the world.
That's why I can talk about my faith by using baseball as my sport. Because baseball is a large part of my life. Although baseball and my friend faiths in like very different topics, there are many similarities that relate to my journey. The first example I want to use to relate baseball to my faith journey is batting averages. If you go on base 3 out of 10 times over the course of your career, you're a Hall of Famer. It's surprising that you are considered an excellent baseball player, and you're getting out 1.5 time. Every time you get up to bat, you have to breathe, like lift your head, even if you've gotten out past 7 times. This requires mental toughness. I think this is like trusting God, because sometimes it's hard to believe that God is listening, but then every once in a while, you see a glimpse of God. I know that God doesn't always make you hit a home run, but I still pray. One time when my team was at a tournament called Sports at the Beach, my team needed me. It's hard to have that much pressure on me. In this instance, I actually hit a home run. And I felt like God was there since I was so nervous. This is part of the reason that I picked Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me as my confirmation. Another example of God giving me strength is from a long time ago when I first moved to Maryland in second grade. I hated it so much. It was so hard because I didn't feel confident. Change is hard for me. And I was afraid to put myself out there to make friends. Since I couldn't take my mom with me to school every day, I wore one of her pins each day on my pants to help me remind me that even if my mom or dad aren't with me, I'm never alone because God is always with me. In a game of baseball, everyone works together to help the team. Everyone has a different job, and nobody's more important than the other. If the team loses, we all lose. If the team wins, we all win. I think this is a lot like the church. Everyone has different skills and even thinks about God differently. But we all work together to make the world a better place. This is one part of the church that I love. In baseball, the coach's job is to help make us the best player that we can be. Coach Gibbs has been one of the coaches that has put a lot of time and energy in me. What makes him stand out is he is cared about my character and not just my ability. Taught me the importance of keeping my emotions in check so I don't do something out of regret. I have a lot of respect for him. Something that is very different for me this year is I go to St. John's College High School, which requires me to take a scripture class. Mr. Longton is my scripture teacher. Even though I've gone to church my whole life and my mom is a pastor, it is interesting to me to have the Bible taught as a class. Probably helps that I'm getting to it in the celebration. I know that I have to keep practicing to be a good baseball player. I think that my faith is similar. I have to put time and energy into it. I know that it is hard to commit, So I'm glad that my high school encourages Christian service hours and is based on Christian ideals. I get little reminders each day about the importance of faith in God. Finally, even though I sometimes don't want to go to church, I'm thankful my mom and dad have brought me to church and continue to teach me that God loves me and I know that they love me. Thank you.